Hey yo everybody, Haku here with this week's read-through video for Boku no Hero Academia. And this week we're going to be doing chapters 34, 35, 36, and 37 if I'm not mistaken. So four more chapters. Last week's video seemed kind of short and I really didn't feel like I rushed through anything. In fact, I feel like I gave a lot of thoughts on stuff last week and we still ended up with like a 40 minute video. So maybe the last four chapters were kind of on the shortish side? I have no clue. It was kind of a weird situation, because I've had some that have taken me over an hour to do. So, yeah, we'll see what this next read-through video has to hold for us, because, of course, it's my first time reading through the series. It looks like we have two special chapters, which are usually just character pages and stuff, that are going to be in this read-through video. Because I think there's like one between chapters 34 and 35, and another between like 36 and 37. So it seems like we'll have two of those little special chapters to read through as well. But yeah, I'm really excited. I haven't recorded this in a week and 2 days, so I'm happy to be recording it again. I like going a week and 2 days without reading after you're marathoning in four chapter spurts. It's really a weird way to do things, but I mean, I don't know. Like, I would mass record ahead of time, but it's like, it takes like an hour to record this. I have school to do, I have other videos to do. It's like, there's no real way I could mass record that much. So I'm just doing it week to week, just taking it week by week. So right now we got chapter 34, Winners and Losers, and I have to skip through all the translator's notes and fan art and stuff to get to the actual chapter now. Let's go, chapter Winners and Losers. Okay, we got some fan art still. I am really actually a little confused at why. I mean, I've heard that it's to fill out a certain number, but I don't really get why all these manga hosting sites do that. They just throw the fan art in the chapters. I've never really understood it. It's kind of odd. Either way, here we are. A quirk unfavored by fate. Shinsu, you who can brainwash. Oh, Shinsu, you can brainwash? Whoa, never heard of that one. I'm jealous. You could have a field day doing crazy bad stuff with a quirk like that. Sets me a bit uneasy. Don't go mind controlling us now, you hear? Says this one old lady looking person. Haha, that's what they always say. The first thing that comes to everyone's minds is its use for evil. And of course, this is a Shinsu flashback. They always basically insinuate that it's a quirk fit for a villain, but I'm used to it by now. It's inevitable, society being the way it is. But you know, and then we see him laying on the ground after being thrown out of the ring by Izuku. Midoriya Izuku, you advance to the next round. Yo, Bakugo, that's the same overhead throw we used on you, isn't it? Says Kaminari. Shut it, drooly. That little bastard. There's no way in hell he didn't aim for that. He was roping him in. The pinpoint power output from the apprehension test and the toss from the battle trial. Rather than capitalizing on his experiences, it's more likely he was pushed to rely on the only experience he could use. And then Izuku was panting. Okay. Checking my recording, making sure it's still okay. Trying to make sure it isn't laggy, because it seems like the site is being a bit laggy today. Yaha, bit of a no-frills battle to start the tournament off, but clap your hands and give these two a round of applause. You fought well, boys. And then we hear the audience clapping. Not that someone as blessed as you would ever understand. No, people with a gateway to success would never understand. Why heroics, Shinsu? Says Izuku. I can't help what I long to be, can I? Then Izuku's still just looking down. Before I inherited One for All, I felt exactly the same way. But now I, no matter what it is, it's... You were so cool, Shinsu, says a voice coming from, it looks like some classmates up in the stands. We were on the edges of our seats, dude, for real. You're like our star of hope for all us Gen Ed kids. You gave the kid who placed the top three from the obstacle a real run for his money. And then Shinsu looks up to him. Okay, on the next page. Okay, that quirk would be incredibly helpful against villains. I definitely want it. Man, Yue must have been idiots to relegate him to their general department. Well, they don't kid about their selectiveness for the heroics exam, so there's bound to be kids who fall through the cracks. Can't be helped. That difference in battle experience, to be knocked out by something like that, what a waste. And it's all of the heroes talking in the stands. Can you hear them, Shinso? You're amazing. Even with these results, I can still come under review to be placed into heroics. And remember this, says Shinso. Even if it's not now, I'm going to qualify for heroics, enter your department, and show you all up as a fantastic fucking hero. Right. He got me. What's he doing? The match is already over, says Izuku, because he's caught because, of course, he responded. Most people would be a bit more apprehensive when talking to me. If you keep this up, it'd be too easy for me to pull the rug out from under you, wouldn't it? So at the very least, don't lose too pitifully out there. Shinso, you... Right. he caught himself again, answering... Recovery Girl Branch Infirmary. There was no way I could put on a smile. Says All Might, well, that must have been painful for you, given Shinso's cries of plight. And yet, I couldn't just buckle and let him win. So this is what it means to aim for the top, right? Says, Izuku. And with that, you're set. And we see his fingers are all bandaged up. You, quit putting all that weird pressure on him, the poor soul, says Recovery Girl, turning around and slapping All Might. It's only because it's absolutely necessary. Ow. Oh yeah, All Might, I must have hallucinated something earlier. Huh? Says All Might. Okay, page loading. There were 8 figures, maybe 9. I'm not exactly sure how many, but when I got that fuzzy feeling from my head... from brainwash, they appeared as though riding on that illusion, and then my fingers managed to move somehow all of a sudden. One among them had your hairstyle. Could it have been the will of the people who wove this power before me? What the? Sounds scary, says I'm like, eh, I thought you'd know about it. Actually, yes, in my younger days I did see something like that. It might even serve as a good way to tell you've gotten a grip on one for all, a milestone of sorts. So that's interesting. There have been around 8 people with the ability before Izuku. I think they're just the imprints of those who used one for all. It's not the sort of thing where they'd have a will with which they could intervene on your behalf. In other words, it's not the illusion you saw that broke the brainwashing. Rather, it was your unwilling of willpower that caused that vision to appear and broke the spell. Even if just for a split second, even if just your fingertips, isn't it easier to conclude that you simply overcame it on your own? Honestly, I can't say I'm totally satisfied with that explanation, but don't dwell on it, or do you just want to sit there and waste your chance to observe your next opponent? Ah, thank you so much, both of you. It was nothing. He said you were there too, says Recovery Girl. That's a good thing, says All Might. Then we see Todoroki in the hall. Out of my way. Your behavior has been nothing but disgraceful, Shoto, says Endeavor. Okay, waiting. If you had used the power at your left side, you could have crushed both the obstacle race and the cavalry battle easily. Your resistance is childish and tiresome, so stop fucking around and see to your duty to surpass All Might. Has it penetrated yet? You're different from your older brothers. You are my great masterpiece. So, Shoto has brothers as well. Is that all that will ever spew out of your goddamn mouth? I will earn my victories using only Mom's power, and I will never, ever use your power in battle. Even if that works for you now, in high school, you'll reach the limit soon enough. Agreed. I think he'll end up finding a healthy way to use both. Psychologically healthy, that is. Physically, I think it is most healthy if he uses both to balance out each other with his body temperature, from the explanation we were given. Sorry to keep you waiting, folks. Next up, it's these two. And then we see Izuku getting back to the stands with Ida and Uraraka. You must be tired. We kept a seat for you. Then the next one up. He's turned in an excellent performance to make it this far, and yet, what's with that plain Jane expression? Does it ever come off? Sato Hanta of the Heroics Department, oh geez, versus you who stand at the top of the top, he who is way too damn strong, from the self-same department of heroics, Todoroki Shoto. Start. I don't know if I've got a shot here, says Hanto, but... And then he slings the tape out of his elbows and ties Todoroki up. I definitely ain't rolling over either. A lightning-quick surprise assault, aiming for a ring out, almost without a doubt the best choice he could have made. Earnestly, give it your all, Sato. Sorry, says Todoroki, it looks like. And then, holy shit, massive column of ice shooting out the top of the stadium. We see it's going right by Ida and Izuku's faces. And then looks like a present Mike with his face pressed up against the glass. Man. Too OP. A little much, don't you think? Says Sato, trapped in his waist up to ice. Sato, can you move? Says Midnight, halfway covered in ice as well. No, I can't move. Sato Hanta's unable to move. Don't mind, kid. You did good. It's all right. I'm sorry I overdid it, says Todoroki, walking to him. Don't mind. I was just a bit pissed. Amidst the chorus of don't minds that naturally sprang up, the back of this man, strong yet doleful, the image of him melting with his right hand what he himself had frozen, just seemed to me somehow insanely sad. And so Todoroki Shoto advances to the next round. Number 34, end. So, now we have Izuku's opponent. That was actually a really good chapter. I'm glad we at least got to see what happened with Todoroki and Sero. I guess I'm just really glad we actually got to see it. I hate when stuff like this skips over fights and stuff when we have it. I know it's necessary for a lot of the lesser-known characters, but I do hope we at least get to see some of each of the fights. So now we're at actually 34.5, this is one of those two extra chapters I mentioned that are probably just character pages or something. Oh, nope, we got a little teeny comic spoof. Translator's notes, this is a spoof of a real-life long-running panel show discussing politics live until morning. Today on live until the early afternoon, says possible best girl mount lady, we'll be discussing the issue of whether or not sexiness is needed in the hero biz with our two lovely guests. Oh, it was just the announcer saying it, and we also have Midnight there as well. No nipple cork. First, Miss Midnight, who currently wields the cane of education and whose risque costume became the talk of the town when she first debuted. This, of course, eventually led to the submission of legislation with specific regard to the exposure of costumes. She's a bona fide veteran who can be said to have moved the whole nation. I'd say it's still pretty wow, says Mount Lady. Well, they're just super sheer tights now, says Midnight. Sorry, blinked out there a second. Depending on the quirk, inadequate clothing can often get in the way of performing. A lot of people used to complain their clothes were obstructing their quirks. So sexiness isn't the goal, and isn't necessary. It's just that what happens to be necessary is often enough appraised as sexy. So I have noticed before that it's actually tights. It just looks like she's wearing nothing and she just doesn't have nipples. But I actually like that they brought that up with skimpy superhero costumes. There are a lot of cases, especially in this universe, they wouldn't be skimpy and sexy just to be sexy. It would be skimpy because, say, your power is similar to Todoroki, producing ice or fire from your body, and it actually comes from your actual skin. Well, if your clothing was getting in the way, it would either block the ice from getting out, or it would trap the fire inside and burn away your clothes whenever you tried to use it. So having something sort of skimpy or resistant would actually make a lot of sense. So I like that. Really, it's just your thing, isn't it? Says Mount Lady. Want to tell me what your deal is? That's some chip on your shoulder there. No, it's just that I think you're really incredible, says Mount Lady. If I were your age, You're saying youth is the only thing that has any merit? Is that all your appeal amounts to? Let me tell you, you're not exactly the youngest yourself. A few people at the top insist on exposing everyone to your top so much, then are we young people supposed to be brought to our knees? How can we compete? Wait, where do you think you're touching? Shut up, I hate you. And this is cat fight. Best episode ever, says Mineta. The true charm to live TV. Okay, that was a cute little thing. And now we're at chapter 35. Let me get some water real quick first, just because, you know, it's like, I don't know. I don't want to get, like, hoarse and raspy halfway through the video. Now comes the third matchup, Kaminari from Class A versus Shiozaki from Class B. And it's over in a flash. Herp, says Kaminari, suddenly stupid. I'll say it again, folks, it's done, finished, not even a contest. Derp, he says, and he's just wrapped up by the thorn hair of Shiozaki. That's a cool quirk. Number 35, Tremble Challengers. That girl's got it going on, huh? Gotta admire that shroud of vegetation, says, Mount Lady. Huh, I admit I've been wanting to see something similar. Now back to work, you, says the, wood dude, whose name I forget. And so, Shiozaki advances to the second round. Ah, I'm so glad the second chance I was given didn't go to waste. I like Shiozaki. Shiozaki Ibarra. Quirk, vines. The vines at her head are extensible. She can even cut some away. All she needs to do to grow them back is to bask in some water and sunlight, so balding is not a concern. That ability of hers to trim it away proved a big obstacle since he got wrapped and bound in that defensive wall of hers that basically sealed Kaminari's quirk. She had the advantage, but if he had played his cards right, he could have righted himself, but instead he panicked and fired off all of his juice. And now we see Uraraka with the muttering going on beside her that we know, of course, is Izuku, and he's writing in his notebook, Kaminari's quirk should by all rights be quite powerful. However, Shiozaki placed fourth in the entrance exam. Might not her vines be the same as those of Kamui of the Woods? As expected, her strength lies in binding and restraint. It's not often you see that binding unraveled. It's simply not possible to edge in any attacks while dodging her invulnerable vines, so in the end your only recourse is to tear them off through pure force. But no, ah, of course, how simple. Naturally, it's for that very reason she aims to bind you to begin with. I see. Uraraka's face looking over at him is perfect. Oh my gosh. It only just ended, and you're already forming counter-strategies based on how you see it playing out, says Uraraka. It's just, what do I do? It's always been a bit of a thing for me. And seeing as this is my chance to observe the amazing quirks of everyone outside our class. Oh, speaking of which, I actually compiled tons of notes on everyone in Class A, too. That includes your zero gravity, too, Uraraka. All of her reaction faces. You've been incredible since we first met, but during the sports festival, you've been giving off more of a, well, serious business vibe. All right, here comes the next matchup, Sprint to the Top. Okay, match four. He's coming across like a center fielder. It's Ida Tenya of the Department of Heroics versus she who is fully decked in support gear, Hatsune Mei of the Department of Support. What sort of match will we be laying witness to? And what is that? Is that a full array of support items on you too, Ida? What the heck? As a general rule, heroics kids are prohibited to use any, though. You need to apply for permission beforehand in cases where it might be an obstacle. Ha, I'm afraid I forgot. Since Aoyama has his belt equipped, I thought it was okay. Yes, since he applied. I apologize profusely. However, my heart was moved by that girl's superb sportsmanship, says Ida. In spite of the fact she's from the support department, she told me, we're all on equal footing now that we've come this far, so I want to equalize the fight, and so she granted me all of these items. Thereby she showed me her mettle, her grit. I thought it would be small of me not to wield her works in this battle. Adorable. God, you're so inexperienced. Is it really okay? Well, if they're both of the same mind on the matter, then it's not outside the realm of permissibility, I suppose, says Aizawa. But wait, is Hatsume really the kind of person to say something like that? Is she, by any chance, actually, says, Izuku? Foo-foo-foo, she says. Start. And then, Ida starts running towards her. I figured, wouldn't this be, like, a trap? Acceleration, it's fantastic, isn't it, Ida? Huh? A mic, he says. Hatsume's just yelling toward him. I trust your legs feel lighter to lift than normal. Well, I'll tell you why. It's because those leg parts are designed to follow in line with the motions of their lucky wielder. So she pretty much made him a bit of an Iron Man suit. But of course, evading is still easy as pie. That is, as long as you've got this hydraulic attachment bar. She says, pushing herself out of the way. Now, where were the seats with the support company execs? Hatsume Mei. Quirk. Zoom. If she really focuses, she can even see things 5 kilometers off as easy as day. Oh yeah, they're into it. What's the meaning of this? Ida says, turning around. Now, feel how beautifully you can shift directions, Ida. It's only possible through that lovely auto balancer. What even is this? Says Present Mike. She's got a strong will, all right, to sell her products, says Aizawa. And so, their game of cat and mouse continued on for 10 straight minutes. Hatsune all the while using that opportunity to explain the features of her items. After which... Phew! Everyone was able to view my lineup so thoroughly. And now I have nothing to regret. And she just walks out of bounds. Hatsune is out of bounds. Ida advances to the second round. You played me for a fool, says Ida on his knees. Sorry about that. Thanks for letting me use you. You're not earning any points from me, you... There's no doubt she saw how super earnest Ida is, and fed him a nice-sounding line so she could take him for a ride. She's not really that frank or honest. She's actually the type who'll do whatever it takes to accomplish her goals. Wow, says Izuku. I'm going to the waiting room for a sec. I'll be back, says Uraraka. And then, Izuku sees her walking away, all jelly. Then we see, Midna dodging Dick Laser Dude's lame Dick Laser. Athlete waiting room number 2. You must be tired, huh, Ida? Oh, it's you, Uraraka. Is that you? Your brow was so wrinkled. My brow, she says. I don't get why there are so many people that don't like Uraraka. All of her faces are hilarious. Ah, I'm just so nervous. It must have gone to my brow. Oh yeah, your matchup is against that Bakugo fellow. Yeah, and I won't lie, I'm super scared. But even so, and we see Mina using her acid. I saw you when you said that, you know, and I... Hey, Uraraka, says Izuku, busting in the room. Deku, but are you okay with not watching everyone's matches? Midoriya, what was with that support girl? Oh, they all ended rather quickly. Short fights, really. And now it's Kirishima versus that Class B kid. Okay, so I'm assuming that, Mina won? Ashido caused Aoyama's belt to malfunction, and the moment he panicked, she snuck in a one-hit KO straight to his jaw. And Tokiyami won by striking first and making sure Yahirozu could never use any of the things she prepared. Man, in a one-on-one brawl, he's pretty close to the strongest there is. Okay, that's cool. Yahirozu, I would have liked to see her and Tokiyami's fight. I like both of them. In that case, then soon the next match will also, and then we have Tetsu and Eijiro fighting. But you know, mightn't even someone like Bakugo go easier on a female opponent? Nope, he won't, says Izuku. Everyone here is giving it their all to become number one and achieve their dreams. So it's inconceivable for Kachan, of all people, to stay his hand at all here. You've saved me so many times, Uraraka, so I thought I'd help you out in my own way, if only a little. This is a strategy I drafted against Kachan based on your quirk, he says, holding up a notebook. It's super hasty last-minute stuff, but this is what I came up with. Oho, you must be pleased, Uraraka. Thank you, Deku, she says. And we see Tetsu getting a punch off on Eijiro, but it's all right. Huh? You're amazing, Deku. You've already entered the spotlight so incredibly quickly. For the cavalry thing, I said I'd rather team up with friends, but if I'm being truly honest with myself, I realized I may have just been counting on you to pull through again. That's why when Ida said he was challenging you, I grew a little ashamed of myself. Uraraka, he says, and that's why. It's all right. Everyone's duking it out with their futures in mind. So really, everybody's each other's rivals. Okay, Lone. Let's meet up at the final match, she says, giving a thumbs up. The matchup of nearly identical quirks, Tetsu versus Kirishima. It was a full-on close-quarters punch-up, but who the victor is? They're both down, it's a draw. In the case of a draw, after they both come to, the match will be decided by a simpler game. We'll have them arm wrestle for the right to advance. Right. So in the end, their strength and toughness are practically equal, huh? Gotta admire how heated they looked. It's definitely boost morale to have one or both of them as sidekicks. It did definitely boost morale. Okay, that makes much more sense. The next match is that match. The match that's bound to be the most upsetting, says Suyu. I feel like I might look away the entire time, says Jiro. You can do it, Uraraka, thinks Izuku, and then we see Katsuki walking up to the stage. It's the last match of the first round. The boy who's been somewhat famous since middle school, but that face ain't the face of a kid on the straight and narrow. Bakugo Katsuki of the Department of Heroics. Versus the kid I'll be rooting for, Uraraka Ochiko of Heroics as well. Downright evil charisma versus a beauteous soul of a girl. Number 35, end. Okay, that was a really good chapter. It was actually shorter page-wise than the others were, it seems. But that one was really, really good. I really enjoyed it. I liked that we did get to see a bit of the Tetsu and Kirishima fight as they were talking. That was at least somewhat good. So I'm liking that we did actually get to see it. And I liked Hatsume Mei, of course, with Ida was very funny. Really, once again, just another solid chapter, and I'm really liking this arc, because you guys know I really like tournament arcs. So, we have My Hero Academia Volume 4. I would have liked to see more of every fight, but at least, like I said, we did get to see a little of pretty much all of them except Yaoyorozu and Tokuyami, sadly. Because I'm not counting that one panel as really anything, you know? Okay. Trying to get through all this fan art and translator note stuff so I can get to the actual chapter here. And it looks to be another character thing. Yeah, just some drawings from the mangaka. Some more drawings from the mangaka. Okay. Smexy Ashido, Yaoyorozu, and Hagakure picture. Okay. Another one of those things like they had at one of the other things where it's just all the character names and a big picture of all of them. Still trying to get through, but this thing is loading so slowly. Hatsume Mei. Likes chocolate and steampunk. Okay, hang on. Okay, here we go. Hatsume Mei is 16 years old, likes chocolate and steampunk, okay, in support department. At first she's going to be a guy, but then I thought it'd be more interesting if she was a girl. I've done the gender swap thing a lot. I really like her design. Those in the departments of support are aiming to work at design agencies that cater to heroes with items and costumes. Item and costume development requires a license. They're offered after being checked by a national oversight. Moreover, in order to be able to use such items and costumes, hero qualifications are usually necessary. Working with things made in labs as experiments and tests is okay, though in addition, for people who those quirks are impediment to their everyday lives, special items can be approved and passed through a rigid national screening. I like that the author brought that up, because I've been wondering this whole time. You have these useful quirks, but if that is the case, then you also have quirks in your world that are essentially like genetic mutations in a bad way, like the genetic mutations of today. What if somebody's born with a shrunken bum arm that's what the quirk did to them? I mean, that's got to be a harsh life to live, even harsher than, say, something like that happens to you in today's world. That happens to you when there are people out there breathing fire and flying and stuff. So I like that for things a bit more serious than that example, like things that are a life-threatening thing or a life-hindering thing, they can have special items to help them with their negative quirk. Because, of course, if there are positive quirks that help you and make you a hero, there have got to be negative quirks that negatively affect your health and ability to live, really. So I do think that it's interesting, and I think the author would benefit from getting into that in the story in the future. Just putting something in there about maybe a character whose quirk is a negative, I think that would be interesting. So yeah, and that's pretty much it. Those are just some thoughts for the series' universe. 18 plus only hero, heroine Midnight. Age 31, Kayama Nemuri. Okay, likes youth and thrills. The inside story. Don't know if you believe me, but when I was thinking her up, she was going to be Class A's homeroom teacher. However, that role would have necessitated saying rather harsh things, and after considering their respective appearances, I switched the role over to Aizawa. I received multiple queries asking what's with her costume. I drew an omek for Jump Next answering this, but the short answer is ultra-thin tights. Too bad. Translator's note, with her name, we know her power. Her name is the kanji for aroma and sleep. Okay, interesting. Monoma Nato 15, and then we have him, likes French cooking, Franco-Belgian comics. Okay, not gonna... I love his models. They used a model for him, just skimming through really quickly. Okay. Cementos, or Ishiyama Ken, in the civilian clothes. Civilian clothes are kind of odd. Okay. Extremely capable in urban settings. In mountains or natural settings, not so much. I begin to wonder, why didn't I give him a flat top haircut? Okay. Got it. Moving on. Tetsu, 15. I hope he brings up that name. I don't have anything in particular to write here, but if I'm being pressed for a comment, I guess I'll just say I was able to give him a design I think is fairly likable. I want to draw him in action really soon. Okay, that's all he said. Okay, never mind then. Moving on, whenever it loads. Kendo Itsuka looks a bit click-click. I liked her when we just saw her in those few little panels that we saw her in. Her civilian clothes. It's not even gotten around to her proper introduction, but my editor and staff strangely already think the world of her. Click-click-click-click. She's the class president of Class B, a bit masculine and strong-minded. She doesn't look masculine, my boys. Click-click-click. Okay, let's move. Come on. Shiozaki Ibata. I like Shiozaki as well. That's a cute outfit. Originally, she was going to be a part of Class A, but at some point, she became Class B. I don't remember why. Person of tender mercies. Hates deceiving or countermining others. Quite the sporting spirit. I like Ibata. Shinzo Hitoshi. He likes cats and cycling. Okay. Born upon waking up from a night's sleep, brainstorming on the topic of an ability that'd make you go, if you were able to do that, what would you do? An ability that would always result in being used for evil at first, and what illegal ideas one would think of for that ability. Soon I might be needing to come face to face with my own naming sense. Okay. Yeah, because the name means heart manipulating people user. Yeah, not a very good namer, I will admit. Tetsu is the kind of top pinnacle of that naming. Ashido Mina, 15. Mina, click, click, click. I always said I like Mina. Right now, she's up there with Yayurozu as my favorite, but I also like Kyoka a lot. I like all the girls from Class A. in different ways, but she likes dancing, Nato, and Okra. Oh, Mina's my girl. She might be waifu now. I am a man who loves Okra. So yeah. Inside story, victim of circumstance. Due to bad luck, I wound up all the way here without ever getting to show her off. What I've drawn of her has been painfully plain. Among the girls, she's the one I'm most anxious to get moving. She ranks high up there, even taking the whole class into account. I want to properly draw her strong points someday. Good. Then that looks to be it. Okay, I really like that. I like getting to look into some of the characters here. Okay, let's get to chapter 36, and then we'll be doing 37 as well. And then that's it, right? 34, 35, 36, and 37? All right. Okay, let's get a sip of water before we start this. Now we have Katsuki. Yo, you're the bitch who floats shit, right? I'm talking to you, Angel Face. The bitch who floats shit. The power gap between them is massive. Does Ochigo really have any chance of winning it all? If you're gonna withdraw, do it now. An ouch during the match won't cut it. And then it says Angel in quote beside her face. What was the counter strategy you came up with for her against Bakugo, says Ida. Oh, that. It's really not all that brilliant or anything. It's just that Kachan is undeniably strong, and in a close quarters brawl, he's got almost no openings to speak of. And if you factor in the mobility of his quirk, or the mobility his quirk gives him, he's even stronger. That being said, while it's true he has maneuverability in midair as well, if she can cause him to float, she can gain the initiative from there. So that's why. Okay, loading. And they hit us with some fan art. Okay, I'll never freaking understand. She needs to strike fast. Start. And okay, butt shot of Uraraka. Okay. Withdraw. I don't have that option. If by some slip he gets tapped, he'll start floating, so we won't want to draw her too close. So if Kachan is thinking what I think he's thinking, and then we see Tokiyami on the other side of Izuku, yeah. He's not going to evade, he's going to strike back head on. Kachan usually leads with a big right swing. Here, dodge here. Yo, and then she goes in and we see the explosion. Holy hell, is he really going all out on her? Against a girl as an opponent? Ugh, this is bad, she says. I know this is bad, but I can't react. Right, now die, he says. And then she jumps out of the smoke behind him. Don't underestimate him. And then he hits the coat that she left behind. She left it behind floating to make him think it was her in the smoke. Awesome. Wow, she made her jersey float as a decoy. Yo, she must have done that on the fly. Ninja. Now if I can just make him float here. And then he slings his arm back and causes another explosion to send her flying back. Eh, he's keeping a sharp eye out before making any moves, says Hanto. With that reaction speed, not even a smoke screen's any use. Huh, the kid's scary, says Kaminari. Uraraka's quirk is such that it only activates if she touches her target. Against those ridiculous reflexes, the odds are against her for sure. Yet undaunted, without pause, Uraraka pushes anew. Too slow, says Katsuki. And then he causes another explosion. Ura! She yells, pushing through. Ochko, says Tsuyu. I don't get it. Does he swing the other way, or... says Mineta in the background. I'm still standing. She's pressing on her charge without a moment's rest, but seeing this, that decoy didn't work. At this rate, he's gonna burn her. That guy, what an idiot, says Minoma. Yo, you sure it's okay to let it go on like this? Looks like a pretty shitty situation. And we see Cementos down below. I can't stand to keep watching, says somebody. Hey, do you mean to be a hero with conduct like that? If your strength level is that much bigger, just blow her out of bounds already. How dare you toy with a girl like that? Yeah, that's right. And the stands stand to boo at him. That's the thing I always don't get about this stuff, though. like, oh, fighting a girl, that's, isn't that a bit sexist? I mean, not to call things sexist that aren't sexist, but she has superpowers too. I mean, she can fight him, she can defeat him, so I mean, you know? Oh yeah, I've gotta say I agree. Huh? You elbowed me, says Present Mike, catching an elbow from Aizawa. What are you... Who just said he's toying with her? Are you a pro? How many years? If you said that in your right mind, then there's no meaning for you to keep watching. Do us all a favor and go home. In fact, you ought to keep watching the match at a career turnover site. Yo, Aizawa going off. Aizawa-sensei. He clearly recognizes the strength of an opponent who's reached this far, and is on guard as a result. See, Aizawa knows what's going on. It's because he's doing everything in his power to win that he's refusing to let his guard down or stay his hand. She's still at it, this bitch. She still ain't dead. And Uraraka's still just standing there. I guess this is it. Thank you, Bakugo. Thank you for not letting your guard down, says Uraraka. Huh? Regardless of Bakugo's distance from the stands, the pros who started booing without noticing should be ashamed of themselves. She stuck to a low profile and kept charging in order to draw Bakugo's attention downward, all the while stockpiling her weapons. Furthermore, she made sure her ceaseless attacks and smokescreen would narrow his field of vision, and we see a bunch of rubble floating in the sky. She about to Fujitora this man! She never let him cotton on. I win, she says, raining the rubble down. She's about to Fujitora this bitch. Oh my gosh, that was good. A meteor shower. Pay more attention, says Aizawa. She made such a desperately risky plan. Uraraka, and he's sending an explosion upward to try to block it. With this much rubble, no matter if he tries to dodge or blast him, it'll definitely open him up to another attack. In that instant, I'll close in with my super move. This is it. I'm gonna win, in advance, just like Deku. And he, of course, he sends the explosion upward at it. And it looks like it knocks her backwards as well, and it's a big freaking explosion. Yeah, she gets sent backwards as well. I know you're hanging out with Deku, bitch, so I knew you had to have something up your sleeve. You're kidding. In one hit, says Uraraka. He must be content with himself with that explosive showing. He took Uraraka's secret stratagem and unreservedly crushed it. That was close, he says. For the time being, this is my absolute limit. It totally fell flat, thinks Uraraka. That's it. The real match starts now, Uraraka. But I can't give up, she says. And then she collapses. My body won't do what I tell it to. Her weight limit, says Izuku. Ah. Man, that was really good. Oh man, it's still going. She must have gone well past it. I can still, she says with midnight stopping. Daddy. That's just such an awkward thing to say. Uraraka is unable to move. Bakugo advances to the next round. Her desperate bid, all for naught. Next issue, a lead color page. Yo, that was a really good one. I really like that one. Okay. Yeah, I really, really liked that chapter. That might be one of my favorite ones so far. That was a good fight. Next, we'll have chapter 37 whenever it decides to finally load. I loved Uraraka's plan. I loved Aizawa standing up and saying, you know, they're equals. Like, that's why they're fighting like this. That's why he's not going easy on her, because she has every chance of beating him. Okay. He who had nothing, he who was handed everything. Chapter 37, Midoriya and Endeavor. Okay. Let's get some water before we read this last chapter. Chestitis. Let's meet up in the finals, and then Izuku's thinking back to what Uraraka said. She swung with a major offensive beyond expectations, but she still came short, and so Ochko tastes defeat. Bring her to recovery, girl, says Midnight. I know, says the robots. Ah, Uraraka. Bakugo breaks past the first round. If you're gonna do it right, says Aizawa. Alright, now that I've collected myself, the first round is now over. We'll get right back to it after a short break. Aren't you supposed to be impartial? Then we see Katsuki walking up and seeing Gizuku. Ah, Kachan. Yo, what the fuck did you think you were doing? Why don't you just fucking die, you piece of shit? Huh? No, my match is next, so I was just gonna get ready in the waiting room, and congrats on the first round. Why don't I just die? Well, bye, he says, walking away. You put that shitty plan in her head, right? The plan that she had her fling herself so dangerously? Don't fuck around and bust my goddamn balls. No, that's not it. The plan, all of it, was what Uraraka herself came up with to beat you. So if anyone was busting your balls, then it was Uraraka who was tossing you around. And then he seems even more angry. Okay, moving on. Yo, hey, that was nearly as tough as your face's villainy, says Hanto. It was a weird matchup, but you played an amazing little heel nonetheless, Bakugo, says Tsuyu. Shut up. Just shut your goddamn mouths. But damn, man, you're able to blast a fragile little girl with abandon, says Kaminari. Knowing me, I'd end up not going through with it despite myself, he continues. But you got beat pretty easy, Kaminari, says Tsuyu. Hey, come on now, Tsuyu. And then we see Katsuki plopping down in the seat beside Jiro. Where do you see fragile? He says. Damn, guess I lost, she says, laughing at the waiting room. Huh? I thought I'd be able to make it to the finish and got carried away. Damn it. Uraraka, are you hurt? I got recoveried, but not so as to shave off too much of my stamina. She went easy on the recovery power and left a few nicks and bruises here and there. Okay. God, Bakugo is really that damn strong. He really annihilated me. I've got to step it up and give it my all, too. And then, Izuku's just sitting there silently. You okay? I'm fine. I'm even surprised how fine I am. Deku, you always look straight ahead, and because I lost, I can't stand to lose again. Don't say, ow, now we know who between Kirishima and Tetsu will advance. Okay? Then we see Kirishima won the arm wrestling. Good job, man. And so the tie is decided and the winner is Kirishima. Guo, not metal fatigue. If only I had ingested more iron, he says. That was a fine match, says Eijiro, putting out his hand. And with this, we have all of our contenders for the second round. Speaking of which, keh, says Tetsu, shall we begin shortly? Already, says Izuku. Well, that's me. Ah, sorry, Deku. Because of me, you weren't able to prepare at all. I'll watch, so do your best. And then he leaves and we see Uraraka picking up her phone. Sorry about dropping the call, Dad. Okay, moving along. Nah, I'm sorry for bothering you when you're busy, hon. But we watched you on TV, me and your ma. You were so close, but you did incredible. It wasn't close and wasn't incredible. At the end, I panicked way too much and ended up having no strategy for a breakthrough. I got slaughtered. Well, I can't say that I really get any of that difficult sounding stuff. But just because you lost doesn't mean your path is closed off, does it? You got next year too, don't you? But I wasn't able to advance, she says. I couldn't show off how I'd handle all the different types of people and stuff. There's no way scouters will get what I'm about with just one fight. What are you in such a hurry for? Don't you understand? I've got to do good by you two. As soon as I'm telling you, Ochko, it's fine. There's no rush. I know, my sweet, kind Ochko will without a doubt become a great hero. And then she's crying. Of course she's hurting. There's no way she couldn't be, thinks Izuku. Even if I told her, I'll do whatever I can to help. I still wouldn't be able to do anything for her. If anything, I'll watch, so do your best. Once again, she's the one having my back. And then he runs into Endeavor in the hallway. And his face. Oh, gosh. Aho, so you are here, says Endeavor. Endeavor, what are you doing in a place like this close up to him? The pressure he exerts is intense. You made a huge showing for me. What a wonderful quirk. Such wind pressure with just the flick of a finger. Yes, in terms of pure power, it's a quirk to rival All Might's power. What are you getting at? I need to get going now. Does he know? No. From what he said, it doesn't seem like he knows. In any case, he's the absolute last person I want finding out about it. My Shoto has a duty to surpass All Might. His match against you will no doubt prove an excellent test bed. So you do your best not to give him a disgraceful match. And then he thinks back, I'll never use my shitty old man's quirk. No, I'll become number one without needing to. This is my total disavowal of him. That's all I wanted to say. Now, excuse me, I know it's time. I'm not All Might, says Izuku. It's obvious, right? Says Izuku, cutting him off. And Todoroki isn't you, says, turning back to him. Okay, load. So, you got All Might's eyes on you, huh? You came, says Todoroki. And now for this go-round of the sports festival, both competitors are at the top of their class, and the world ain't big enough for the both of them. My Hero Academia, number 37, end. Okay, so that's... Oh, nope. Now we have Midoriya versus Todoroki. We have another page. Start. Okay, then that seems where we're going to end, I would think. Yep. So, yeah. I guess that's it for this week's video, read-through, all that. Just making sure that there's nothing else. And, yep, that's it. So next week we'll do 38, 39, 40, and 41. Yeah. This was actually maybe the best so far for the best grouping of four chapters. I thought that these were really, really good. The last chapter, of course, was necessary setup, and I thought it was really, really good for Ochako's character. I think her name may actually be pronounced Ochako, but Ochako just rolls off the tongue easier and easier to say. I think it's actually pronounced Ochako, and there's more of a... You actually pronounce the cha in it more, but Ochako's way easier to say for me. So yeah, I really honestly liked all four of these a lot. I loved the chapter with the Katsuki and Uraraka fight. Nothing bad to say about any of them. And I'm looking forward to round two and seeing all of our matches there. Hopefully we see our matches there. Yeah, that's about all I got. So thank you guys once again for watching this week, and I'll be back next week for the next four, like I've already said. Like if you did like this video, comment down there. Tell me what you thought of these four chapters and what you thought of my thoughts on them and all of that, whatever you want. Subscribe for more Boku no Hero Academia and a ton of other things on the channel, manga, anime, and a ton of other things. Follow on Twitter if you want as well. I'll try to keep you updated there as best I can for stuff going on, and that's it. So thank you once again for watching, and I'll see you all next time.